FT2 chip soldering tutorial. The FT2 chip from Pyroterra Lighttoys is an advanced addressable LED radio controller. It allows you to build your own light constructs and props while supporting easy programming via LTcomposer software. In this video, we will show you the basic hardware setup. Parts you will need: FT2 chip, LED strip, FT remote, and power source. Start with soldering tin to the required pads on the chip. Power source pads. Turn the chip upside down and solder tin on the digital output 1 pads. Now let's connect your LED strip. Pay attention to the pinout of your strip and connect it to the correct FT chip pads, as shown on the graphic. Now it's time to add the power source, usually 1 cell lithium battery. When finished, you can try out whether your chip works by a 2-sec button press. You can now confirm that the chip will charge your battery by connecting a USB-C cable. Your FT2 chip is ready and you can test it out. First, start with pairing it to your remote. Long press the FT2 chip's button until you'll see white color on the LEDs. Turn on the remote. Hold the pair button. When paired, let's connect it to the chip will blink twice and display a pink color. Hold pair button again. Now you should be paired and ready to test out your new FT2 chip with the basic remote functions. Software part. To fully set up your FT2 chip to match your desired layout, you will need to connect your FT2 chip to a computer and open the LTcomposer software. It is possible to connect the remote instead and have the FT chip paired to it, but we recommend to connect the FT2 chip directly via cable. You need to go to the Devices menu. Click on FT2 device. When you click on it, the chip's LEDs will flash white to help you identify the device. Click on Factory Config. A new window will appear with FT2 chip configuration. You can change the device name, the type of LED strip you will be using, AB function, and its split point. Change brightness. It is automatically calculated from the set resolution. Beware, if you set it higher, FT2 chip might not be able to handle white color at maximum brightness, and it will automatically lower the brightness. Then the AB type line shows you how the AB remote function will behave. The pink line shows you which LEDs will be used for the A segment and the blue line for the B segment. The next line is digital output 1. Here you set the number of LEDs connected to this output. If you won't be using FT2 chip's second digital output, you will want to start with 0 and end with a number of LEDs your prop has minus 1. Or vice versa, depending on how you want to send data to display on your LED strip. Now you are ready to save your settings. Hit the Apply to the device button. Wait for it to be confirmed and your chip is ready to go. Thanks for watching.